कितना सा फर्क है कुछ होने में और बहुत कुछ होने में। इतना सा फर्क है एक बार सोच के छोड़ देने में और लग के कर दिखाने में। मान लेने में कि जिंदगी ऐसे ही कटेगी और सुबह 4 बजे उठ के सोचने में ये अभी तो बस शुरुआत है। किसी मैगजीन को हाथ में लेने में और उसी मैगजीन के कवर पेज पे होने में इतना सा ही तो फर्क है। VIP सीट में और उसकी पिछली सीट में इतना सा ही तो फर्क है। वो जिसका मैदान ही खुला आसमान है वही कल जमीन पर तो था। पूछोगे तो बताएगा वो पंछी। ये एक दायरे में सिमटने में और पूरी दुनिया को दायरा बनाने में बस इतना सा फर्क है। इतना कितना है, इतना है या इतना है, जो नापेगा वो जाने कि जहां धरती और आसमान मिलते हैं, नानकुर से दूर अगर मगर शायद से दूर, वहां भी दोनों में फर्क बस इतना सा है। धरती और सातवें आसमान में फर्क बस इतना सा है। ये एक अंतर प्रेरणा है, ये हमारी आपकी हम सब की अंतर प्रेरणा है। एक कदम, एक छलांग, एक बाजी, एक गहरी सांस और एक ललकार खुली हवाओं में कि हाँ मैं बना हूं उन फिजाओं के लिए, कि हाँ मैं बना हूं उन ऊंचाइयों के लिए जो ऊंची तो बहुत है पर नामुमकिन भी नहीं, क्योंकि मुमकिन और नामुमकिन में बस इतना सा फर्क है। धूप छाओं में फर्क बस इतना सा है। तो बस चलिए फ्रेंचाइज इंडिया के साथ ये फर्क मिटा देते हैं। फ्रेंचाइज इंडिया, 20 इयर्स ऑफ आइडियाज।
Thank you so much, Kanika, for playing the corporate video of Franchise India. Yes, it's our aim every day to provide maximum business solutions to all our investors through our digital and physical show. And on the same line, now we are presenting our iconic, we are inviting all of you to our iconic brand webinar. We welcome each and every investor, those who have joined us today to understand the iconic brand journey Gyani. Yes, today we are presenting the brand Gyani. It's a heritage ice cream brand of India. Why we say heritage? Because they enjoy the legacy of 65 years and they are currently operational with 100 plus outlets pan India. It is our privilege that today we are joined by Mr. Taranjeet, who is a managing director and managing director at Gyani. We also welcome and invite Sonia Ma'am. She's a founder at Franwork. We also invite Pankaji, who has joined us from our Gani team, as well as Gaurav Arora. So thank you so much, Taranji. Thank you so much, Sonia ma'am, Pankaji, for joining in today. But Taran sir, before I formally invite you, I would like to invite Sonia ma'am to set the prospect for this particular iconic brand webinar. Welcome, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Harshna. And I'd like to thank all our friends who have joined in and our special guest of the day. We have none other than Mr. Taranjeet Singh, who is here with us, our friends. And he's the MD of the company, Gyani's. And this is a brand, like Harshna mentioned, which is about 65 years old. And they have been serving 100% vegetarian ice creams. The company also have a state-of-the-art infrastructure, which is about 15,000 square feet alone in Manesar and Delhi. And I'm sure a lot of you have joined in, especially from North India, Delhi, NCR. This is a name every home can reckon with. And we're looking at, friends, two partnerships. We're looking at unit partners and also at the same time area franchisees for Gyani's. And I would also like to add that we have been working very, very closely with Taranjeet ji for the last many, many years. And we are proud to say that we have, you know, collectively have been a part of the successful journey which Gyani had in the last many years. And they've grown to the number of locations that we currently see. And also in the last 1.5 months, our teams at Franchise India has very worked very, very closely with the team of Gyani's in helping them finding like-minded and suitable both area and unit franchisees for all across. And before, I request Taranjeet Ji and also Mr. Pankaj, who is the franchise head for Gyanis, to start the presentation. I will request Taranjeet Ji, if you would like to give a little brief about your own journey, how it started, and then we can formally start the webinar. And friends, all of you out there, whatever questions that you have, we'd be more than happy to take any questions which you can use and put in the Q&A box down, and we'll take it up post our presentation is over. Over to you, sir.
Yeah, hi. Thanks for the appreciation. And I'm Taranjeet Singh, as ma'am told you. I'm from Gyani. So as ma'am told, we started our journey. My grandfather started the journey in 1956. So he started from Old Delhi. And that time we used to make rabri faluda and some shakes, like mango shake, pineapple shake, and samosas. And we were popular for basically rabri faluda and mango shake. So we did very well in the market, and we were known for the quality.
Yes. Hi, good evening all. I'm Pankaj Banjanda from Gyani Ice Cream. We have started in 1956 from Chandni Chowk, Fatehpuri, by the name of Gyani the Hatti. And it's we have started with rabri faluda and mango shake in 1956. And after that, in 1980s, we have started the ice cream in 1980s. And in 2007, we have started the franchisee model. As we have some good flavors in that, we have rabri faluda, traditional things also. And we are growing with the generation now. And we have ice cream, shakes, sundaes, sodas, low-fat ice cream, diet-free ice creams also. And we are coming into this vegan plant milk ice cream also. Next, please, Arthana ji. We have awarded Best Ice Cream Franchisee Award in 2015-16, as in 2018-19 also. Next, please. We have doing promotional in the pitches also. Singhis Bling. Next, please. Flying Jet. Next, please. Outlet summary. We have somewhere about 100 plus stores in Pan India. And we are working from good HDs and ice cream management. We have a vision of somewhere about 200 stores across India. Currently, we are covering the city Delhi, NCR, Haryana, Punjab, Uttarakhand, Madhya Pradesh, Himachal, Jammu, Kashmir, Rajasthan, and Chhattisgarh, some part of Jharkhand, city of West India also, and South India, we are also planning for that. And as you know, we had Rabri Faluda also, and we have launched this real fruit ice cream, chocolate ice cream varieties innovation in jamun sorbet also. It's good for diabetic patients. Next, please. We have these two models. One is kiosk model, and second one is shop model. Kiosk model is a QSR station. It's called a quick QSR model. It's a quick service station. It's without sitting, and proper ice cream parlor with this proper sitting. Next, please. Next, please. Favorable market condition, conducting aggressive growth plan. Ice cream frozen market is somewhere from 2007 is 4.5 lakh tons. In 2002 is expecting more than 5.5 lakh tons, and somewhere about a lakh ton is we growing now. Next, please. Format parlor and kiosk, we have minimum area we require 250 for the parlor. And for the kiosk, we require 100 square feet. In that, we will provide you gelatos, shake, exotic sundaes, regular sundaes, milkshakes, ice cream shakes, some smoothies, cup cones, 1 liter, half liter tubs, bricks, and kulfi. Presence across format parlor kiosks are the same. Wide menu offering, we are offering somewhere about 150 products, including ice cream and all. We have a good concept of interiors in the retail market distribution also. Next, please. Next, please. Rollout mapping, we are planning for West Bengal, Bihar, Assam, Madhya Pradesh, and rest part of India, but particularly we're focusing on this areas. Next, please. The network, we have a mixed direct unit master franchisees. In that, we have 2-3 options. One is direct unit, second one master franchisee, and second multi-unit franchisee you can do. You can do as a single direct unit franchisee, single sub franchisee, and multi-unit franchisee. Next, please. This is a basically our financial plan. And I'm starting from ice cream parlor. It's somewhere about 250 square foot. In that, these are the ideal costs. Ceiling, flooring, painting will be somewhere about 2.25. Furniture, woodwork, plumbing will be 1.65. Electrical equipment will be somewhere about 80,000 rupees. Branding, signage, and internal is somewhere about 80,000 rupees. And machinery equipment cost will be somewhere about 4 lakh rupees. POS we are using for that is 50,000 rupees, including the software and printer. Miscellaneous items will be somewhere about 35,000 rupees. License and establishment will be somewhere about 15,000 rupees. The FFCI and the other licenses, stop establishment licenses. Launch and pre-marketing will be expenditure will be paid by both parties by 50-50%, 50-50% sharing basis. And we have a one-time franchisee fee, 5 lakh rupees, and 90,000 rupees is for the GST. Annual sales we are predicting on ice cream parlor will be somewhere about 75 lakh rupees per day, averagely 15 to 20,000 rupees. In that, the food cost will be somewhere about 52.5%, including the wastage and all. 2% royalty for the marketing only. We are not charging any particular royalty for the brand. This is only for the marketing purpose. Staff, we are expecting 7 to 8% expense. Rent will be somewhere about 12 to 14%. Utilities will be somewhere about 4 to 6%. Net margin will be somewhere about 18 to 20%. And ROI will be somewhere about payback period in 18 to 24 months. And the second model is kiosk model that we call QSR model, quick service station. That ceiling, flooring, painting will be 1.75. Furniture, woodwork, plumbing will be 70,000 rupees. Electrical equipment, fitting, lighting will be somewhere about 65,000. Branding, signage, internal, external will be 50,000 rupees. Machinery, we are planning for 3.3 lakh 50,000 rupees for the kiosk. And POS, we are planning 40,000 rupees. Miscellaneous items are the same. License and establishment expenses will be 15,000. Launch and pre-marketing expenditure, 10,000 rupees, each bear by each party, 50-50% on the basis, and 5 lakh rupees, one-time royalty. And in kiosk, we are expecting 12 to 15,000 a day sale, 4.5 to 5 lakh rupees month. Cost of material will be somewhere about 52.5. Royalty will be somewhere about 2% for the marketing. Staff will be 6 to 8%. Rent, 8 to 11%. Utilities will be 4 to 6%. Net margin will be somewhere about 18 to 20%. ROI is expecting in 18 to 24 months. Archana ji, next please. The standard document, we will provide you the operational manual, brand book, recipe book, services book, training book, and marketing book will provide you. And at the start, our expert team will be come over there to see your location and set up the design for your premises. Trade and production equipment sourcing, we are helping you out for the trade and marketing purpose. Marketing strategy development execution, like social media, Facebook and all, we have the backend team will provide you the all backups. Supplies will be through the railways, near the railway station to your nearest station. And marketing, advertising campaign and promotion, social media management, Swiggy, Zomato and other local platform as well. Operation on-site support, we are planning for an area manager who will support you to help you out to how to run the business, how to run the model and planning for the this year promotion and all. The software training will be provided by us. We have outsourced the software by the name of company POSIS. They will provide you the best services. They have a 24/7 best services for the backend team. Next, please. Archana ji, next, please. We have an attractive growing market. India is a young country with growing a per capita income. This is a young population is highly situated for the ice cream. Now the generation, we are growing with the generation now. So we have expanded more than geographically stores in 100 plus units in North India, as well as we have planned in West, East and South also. Outstanding stores of companies, started business since starting in 1950s and multiple business, multiple source of income you have offline, online, both you have, you can do the institutional sales as well as in that we have a catering system also for the franchisees. They have excellent growth presence in Delhi NCR, strong experience with the franchise in Delhi NCR, and we are giving best digit unit revenue growth to our franchisee partners. Thank you.
So thank you so much, Pankaji. Thank you so much, Taranji ji. Now invite Gaurav. I would invite you because you are one of the important filler for this particular brand. I invite you to take all the queries which you want to take from our investor side. And investors and dear friends, I'll request you. We have created question and answer box. You can start putting your queries over here.
Yeah, hi, good evening, everyone. Hi, good evening, Pankaj. So we have heard the presentation and it is really nice that you have given all the insight. But before, on behalf of the viewers and the investors, so we have typically the questions coming from the market and in the view of the investment. So jaise aap investment ke baare mein bata rahe hain ki, so can we run the presentation again? Can we go yes, back to the same presentation?
No issues.
So, but before we get on to that, so आप जैसे किसी भी मार्केट में जाते हैं, सो हाउ डू यू हेल्प योर कस्टमर्स टू बेसिकली सेलेक्ट द लोकेशन, बिकॉज लोकेशन प्लेज द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल व्हाइल वी डू एनी बिजनेस व्हिच इज बेसिकली टू डील विद कस्टमर्स. सो व्हाट आर योर की क्राइटेरियाज ऑन बेसिस ऑफ व्हिच यू सेलेक्ट द प्लेस?
वी आर प्लानिंग फॉर द हाई स्ट्रीट मार्केट एज वेल एज अर्लियर वी आर प्लानिंग फॉर द मॉल्स ऑल्सो वेयर द रेस्टोरेंट कैटेगरी इज मोर देन लाइक और कॉर्पोरेट्स वी कैन प्लान फॉर दैट. And we are planning for the good areas, like the premium area of the cities. And firstly, we'll do a survey over there. After that, we can recommend you the areas like in Indore or in Bhopal, which area you want. We can recommend you the areas as per the city-wise and the markets.
So, kuch aise
like earlier, I'll give you an example of Bhopal. Jaise we have done a market or survey over there. There is a market, it's called 10 number market, and the mall is one mall, and on the highway we have finalized two three locations over there. So before going to any city, now we'll do a survey over there with the good areas and the local team over there. They will help you out for the things, and we will connect it with some dealers also, as well as we have planned to like tie up with Remax also for the local locations and all in the premium market.
Okay, that's really nice. So which means, since you have done the diligence for any new market where you want to set up, to usme kuch aise locations hain, kuch aise predetermined locations hain jahan pe, if we have the location, so then there is no need for any diligence and the investor is like sure shot that they are going to get the result provided the shop is meeting the criteria. So one is the location obviously where you want to set up, and second is the shop which is going to be in use where people are going to pay a visit. So suppose you have selected any A area in Indore or B area in Bhopal, and you have some investor coming in with the ready property in that location. So does it still need to basically visit the location for the diligence, or is it that they can be sure of the sign up and the business there?
No, firstly, every time we will visit the premises over there, because we are putting our board also over there, the brand, and we need to keep the brand will be goes in the right hand. So first we do a survey over there, and we will take two to three days for that. And like if you call us for the any area, so we'll get you reply within 2-3 days. We'll send our team to over there. They will do a local survey over there, the ticket size and all the market, and they will see how much the potential in the market is there. If there is a
residential or competition ko bhi study karte hain isme, do you read the competition also in that local market?
Yes, that's why we do a like a survey over there. That's why we go to over the on the like local players over there with the like premium segment players are there, and we will do a ticket size survey also, ki how much is the capacity of this market they will spend on the food or the ice cream category or the beverages category. After that we will finalize the location.
Which means you do all the probability analysis of success before you are shortlisting any partner, place, geography to set up your business. Right? Yes, and which means it is basically an air-proof business, and it is a high probability in terms of becoming a successful venture. And I'm sure that is the reason today we have such a vintage in the market with over 100 stores in the country, and all the stores are doing great despite the COVID hit or whatever, but we are doing a business. So इसमें हम किसी भी market में जाते हैं तो online offline दोनों का combination से हम देखते हैं output जो हम assessment में देखते हैं, या फिर सिर्फ हम offline का business देखते हैं और online हमारे लिए एक additional source of revenue होता है?
No, we do both of them, like offline and online both. Basically, we first see the footfall of the market. Like the good market is in all, and we go with that area ki where the all the brands are there, like in a good market, and we'll do offline and online both survey we'll do over there. like online we can do from the Swiggy Zomato and Swiggy Zomato and the other local players, and offline though we can do marketing like shop in shop concept. Like they do survey, okay. They went to the shops and do the survey, how was the spending power of the clients over there, like how much they are paying for some foods and snacks and beverages. So
अभी मेरे पास एक इंक्वायरी आया है इन्वेस्टर का, पर्टिकुलरली विद रिगार्ड्स टू स्पेस जो हम बार बार बात कर रहे हैं ज्योग्राफी की. तो ये खांडवा बेसिकली एमपी में देयर इज अ प्लेस राइट वेयर द इंक्वायरी हैज कम एंड शी इज आस्किंग वेदर इज वी हैव अ पॉसिबिलिटी टू कंसीडर खांडवा एज अ पोटेंशियल लोकेशन टू सेट अप अ ज्ञानी स्टोर, और इज इट ओनली बिग सिटीज और द स्मार्ट सिटीज लाइक इंदौर एंड भोपाल वी हैव अ पोटेंशियल. सो एनी व्यूज ऑन दैट?
Yes, we are planning for somewhere about like tier two cities. After we'll go to tier three cities. Khandwa is somewhere in tier three or tier two cities. So once we get the interest of the client, after that we'll do a survey over there, and I'll tell you the things if we were comfortable with that or not. We have to check the logistics also as well. We have to check the logistic for the your stock also.
Right. So Priya ji, I'm sure you've got the answer if you're there. So company is going to basically look at the logistics options, right? Because the operational bandwidth of the company is very important before they decide on any geographical location, and then comes the space. So we will come back to you probably in next 2 or 3 days. I have another query from Mr. Jain. He's interested to take up a master franchisee for the entire MP state. So iske liye Pankaj ji, aap thoda sa agar outline ek bar bata denge, and then we'll take up the inquiry with Mr. Vibhor on one-on-one basis. आपका एक meeting करा देंगे हम इनसे. तो सिर्फ आप अगर दो लाइनों में बता दें कि possibility है, और अगर है तो basically इसमें क्या रहेगा, KRA definition या जो भी आप बताना चाहते हैं on this public platform.
Yes, we have a master franchisee concept also, and we have to analysis for the outlets also. We'll do city wise starting from Gwalior to till the end of MP. And we are planning for the major cities, and supplies we are considering on the same. And in the master franchisee, a benefit of that, you will get some commissions on the bill of the sub franchisees. We will not reduce the margin of some franchisees as well as the master franchisee, same margins. We will put it own from our pocket, the margins we are giving to the sub franchisee. It is called a developer for us. It is a kind of a developer for us for the area. And
So do they need to take the ownership of setting up the sub-franchisee beneath a master franchisee, or is it going to be the company's responsibility, or is it going to be both?
It's not a kind of an investing thing. Once you invest, you have also interest in the brand also. Once you get interest in the brand, you can do like this a both concept.
So it is not just the investment, it is the engagement and the business both. Right.
Yes, that's why we are giving the commissions to the master franchisee. Is a monthly income as they will grow with the franchisee also, and he can get the commissions also, a monthly revenue income. Right. That's why it's interest of the master franchisee to do the business over there.
Great. So Vibhorji, I'm sure you would have got the answer. So in case you are interested to pursue on a master franchisee format for Gyani, then we welcome your inquiry, and we will be able to arrange the call with the brand team as soon as you reach back to us. So you can leave on to your contact details for us, and we'll come back to you on that. Now we have another inquiry from Mr. Hanif. So he's basically from the eastern part of the country, and he's asking on the scope to do business in either Bhubaneswar or Cuttack. So Pankaj, your thoughts on this?
Bhubaneswar, already we have 6-7 outlets over there in Bhubaneswar. We've started in 2017, and now in 2020 till 2019, we have 6 stores over there, and we are aggressively expanding in Odisha. So we can plan in Cuttack, no issues for that. But we have a master franchisee over there. Already we have a master franchisee over there for Jharkhand and Odisha. We have to talk to them, and we can plan for the Cuttack also.
So is it that first you will assess the option to work with Mr. Hanif, and followed by the discussion with Mr. Franchisee, or is it that Mr. Master Franchisee has got right to...
No. We have do concept of a mutual understanding. If he's interested that, we can plan for the meeting, as well as we can do a Zoom call with the Master Franchisee.
And this is going to be a tri-party agreement, or
just tri-party one party? Yes.
Tri-party.
Great. In 2017, they have taken our single franchisee in 2017. in 2019 it became a two state master franchisee, Jharkhand and Odisha. So
great.
Once you get the good revenue, after that you get an interest in that, and he has taken the Odisha and Jharkhand itself.
Great. So Anivji, there is no second thought about your brand becoming successful in any new territory, and hence the existence has been for more than any other brand in the country in this segment. So we are very happy and privileged that you're working. So now we have another question, and it's actually a list of questions which I have from Ms. Tiwari. So she's basically asking that there are three categories of franchisees. So which category of franchisee cost we have assumed in the presentation? That's single the first question we have.
Okay. It's right? A single unit franchisee. It's for 5 lakh rupees is for the single unit franchisee per outlet.
Great. So this is 5 lakh rupees, and the other setup cost and everything is for the unit franchisee, Madhur Tiwari. We have second question from Mr. Tiwari. How are we compete the top and the town or big brand in that area? So I think, Mr. Tiwari, we have already given that answer, that while we basically set up a business in any new geography, we do all this diligence and basis that we decide our counter maneuvers. And before we launch, we are already prepared that how we have to basically create our share in the market, and how we have to pull the basically the taste buds of the customer, and how we have to pull the eyeballs initially. So we have all the marketing and the action plan ready for every new territory as such because of our existence. However, basis the response behavior of the demography and topography, we decide. So any additional input, Pankaji, you want to give here to Mr. Tiwari?
No, already you have said that the same thing I told them. Okay, we will do a survey right over there first. After that, we can finalize the things.
Right. Then another last question that I have from Mr. Tiwari is that, have you considered the shop cost in your presentation? And no, what is the margin difference after considering the cost?
The security so, is Mr. separate. Tiwari,
so generally, what happens is that if the shop is your owned, hai, तो उसका कॉस्ट जो है आपकी उस टाइम पे एसेट की उसको हम कैप्चर नहीं करते हैं बिजनेस में. और इसका सबसे बड़ा एक रीजन ये होता है कि अगर आपकी शॉप की कॉस्ट इन्फ्लेट होती है तो वो जो मार्जिन आप उस पे कमाएंगे तो वो बेसिकली कभी बिजनेस में नहीं डाले जाते हैं. इसीलिए हमेशा शॉप की कॉस्ट भी बिजनेस में नहीं डाली जाती है, राइट? लेकिन अगर उसका कोई नोशनल रेंट है तो वो डेफिनेटली हम बिजनेस में काउंट करके चलेंगे, और आप उसके बेसिस पे अपना पीएनएल बनाएंगे, और आपका सीए आपको उसमें हेल्प करेगा. और अगर वो शॉप की वायबिलिटी आती है कमर्शियल टर्म्स में, जो भी उसका नोशनल रेंट हम कंसीडर कर रहे हैं या अपॉर्चुनिटी कॉस्ट उसमें हम जो कंसीडर कर रहे हैं, उसके बेसिस पे हम बताएंगे कि वो शॉप वायबल है या नहीं है. एंड ऑब्वियसली लुकिंग एट द अदर एक्सटर्नल एनवायरनमेंट प्रिवेलिंग इन दैट मार्केट और इन दैट ज्योग्राफी. सो आई थिंक वी हैव कवर्ड मोर और लेस ऑल द क्वेश्चंस. स्टिल इफ वी हैव एनी मोर क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम पीपल हु आर व्यूइंग दिस प्रेजेंटेशन. विभोर जैन जी का आया है आगे कॉल करना, उन्होंने अपना नंबर दे दिया है. तो मोर और लेस हमारे क्वेश्चंस कवर हो गए. तो मैं अब लास्ट में और छोटे से दो क्वेश्चंस और पूछना चाहूंगा पंकज जी. तो अगर हमारे को बेसिकली किसी इन्वेस्टर से फ्रॉम द स्टार्ट टू एंड, फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट मीटिंग टू बेसिकली द क्लोजर एंड टू देन सेटिंग अप द शॉप, ये पूरा प्रोसेस में बेसिकली क्या टाइमलाइंस रहते हैं? क्योंकि बहुत सारे इन्वेस्टर्स हमारे पास आते हैं जो काफी बेसिकली हरी में होते हैं बिकॉज ऑफ the fear in the mind that they don't want to lose on the opportunity, and we have limited options available in a brand like Gyani, kyunki itna saalon se existence hai, to usme kya timeline rehte hain aur wo timeline mein hum kaise act karte hain?
Sir, it will take somewhere about 35 to 40 days. We have a PPT over there for the proper 30 to 45 days of training planning, like for the first week, okay, second week, third week and all. First week, the licenses and the agreement, GST will be done. I'll tell you in the short, second week, we have a process of the interior, started with the interior and the training part. In the third week, we are planning for the machinery purchase for the outlet, proper the branding and all. And fourth week, we are getting to finalize all the things for the outlet, as well as like the Swiggy Zomato also will get a tie up with that. It will take minimum 30 to 45 days to get it done, all the setup and all.
Okay. Great. So anyone who is looking at setting up a Gyani store in city of your choice, and you have your shop available, regardless you have shop available, you can take on rent, you can dedicate your shop. So company will come and help you to assess the geography, the site, and the and will submit a assessment report of doing the business there, basis which we will be going ahead with the signing of the LOI, and you'll have to pay the franchise fees to the company to become part of it, and then the setup cost and the suppliers and the trainings and the hiring and everything will start after that. So I think that we are now sorted as such that what is the process to be followed here, the overall modus operandi and the overall opportunity which is associated with Gyani. Still, I welcome, in case people have any questions, I'll be happy to answer that, or I hand over this presentation to Archana. So Archana, over to you. So I've already taken more or less all the questions with regards to investment, ROI. So in case somebody from the viewer side would like to ask anything on the investment or on the ROI or anything related to training process, so we would be happy to answer those questions.
We request our investors, if you have any other further query, you can use question and answer box. We can't obviously unmute you because this is a webinar. You can put your questions. We still have 10 minutes to go. So in case you have any further questions, you can definitely ask us.
Archana, we have another question from one of the viewer who has written in my chat box directly. So he's asking me ki, agar mujhe Kolkata mein karna hai, to mere liye basically kya option hai? What is the new market where I have the possibility to do business in Kolkata? So is there any particular geography, any market where I can set up? So Pankaj ji, koi aisa hai hamare paas?
Yes, Kolkata, we are doing a survey over there. So we'll get it done in 2-3 days. Although we have finalized 2-3 locations over there. In Sector 5, we are coming in RDB Mall and Bhavanipur main area. And we are planning for like Park Street, Kamik Street, as well as New Town also. We are planning for that. So give us 2-3 days. We'll share you the the city wise plan, like Calcutta, how much outlet we are planning for that, with the area wise, which area has a good potential of that.
Great. So Mr. Tiwari has asked another question, ki raw material ki availability and manufacturing process kya rahega? To uske liye Pankaj ji aap ek bar bata denge, Mr. Tiwari?
For Calcutta?
Nahi, ye basically jo hai, question hai, इन्होंने अभी location नहीं बताया है, Mr. Tiwari ने. He's basically asking कि हाँ, he's basically asking कि quality process कैसा manage होगा, standards कैसे manage होंगे, और इनका interest mainly MP में है.
Okay. So basically, Mr. Tiwari, we have a standard model of logistics. We will do through railway itself today. But if once we go with a good outlet, number of outlets in MP, we will put up a C&F over there. So they will supply you. Else, at present, we are planning for like 7-10 days for your stock to like store your stock. And ice cream is a good shelf life, somewhere about 6 months. But we will take as a 1 month or 45 days for the fresh. And we will do a supply within every 10-15 days at your nearest railway station. As once we get the C&F done, so we can change the mode of that. They can also plan for your doorstep deliveries also. But they will charge you something like 2-3% for the logistic. Else, the freight will be paid by the company from Delhi to nearest your railway station. And you, at present, you have to pick up from the nearest railway station. And you don't want to have some these insulated vans and all. It's come in proper ice box with proper dryers. You can carry into normal van also, like the loading vans also.
Okay. So we are sorted all more or less. I don't see any new question coming in. Again, the same question, a new question has come from Mr. Pralhad Behra. He's asking for Katak, Odisha. So Katak ke liye hum already kar chuke hain ki hamare paas option hai. Master franchisee ke under hum kar sakte hain. अगर किसी का भी इंटरेस्ट है तो आप हमारे को प्लीज पोस्ट करिए अपना कॉन्टैक्ट नंबर और अलाउ अस टू कॉल यू बैक एंड वी विल अरेंज अ मीटिंग इन पर्सन राइट विद द ब्रांड एंड यू विल बी एबल टू देन गेट फर्दर अंडरस्टैंडिंग फॉर द मार्केट एज सच एंड विल बी एबल टू हेल्प यू टू फैसिलिटेट द फर्दर मीटिंग्स. प्रिया जी का क्वेश्चन आया है कि शी हैज गॉट अ 900 स्क्वायर फीट साइट ऑन द खांडवा इंदौर हाईवे एंड she's asking you to do the research. So, but Priya ji, aap please bata dijiyega. Aap apne, matlab, somebody from our team will get back to you. Aur aap apne site ka ek bar Google coordinates aur layout wagera bhej dijiyega. To hamari team jo hai aapki meeting karwa degi brand ke saath aur brand aapki site ko assess karke hamare ko confirm kar denge. To aapka basically ye deal mature ho sakta hai. Yeah. Arshna, I think we are sorted.
Sure. So thank you so much, everyone, for sharing your questions with us. Thank you so much, Taranji ji. Thank you, Pankaj ji. Thank you, Gaurav, for joining in. Do reach out to us for more queries related to this particular business opportunity or any other business opportunity. Please connect with us at our business hotline number, which is 97176-83838. Also, you can write to us at feedback@franchiseindia.in. We value your suggestion and feedback. Share your valuable suggestion and feedback at Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, or Twitter. Or in case you wish to have a management advice from the management team of Franchise India, connect Gaurav sir and Sonia ma'am at their LinkedIn platform. And tomorrow, we are inviting you to join us for our Business Opportunity Over Chai webinar series, which will start at 12 p.m. We are bringing the brand Zoobox. It's a renowned mobile phone as well as IT product retail opportunity for you. The company already having 10 outlets running Pan India. So don't miss this chance. Join us tomorrow by doing registration. Registration is free of cost and it's very easy to get yourself registered with us. Just go to Facebook page where we have shared the registration link or connect with us at our business hotline number, which is 97176-83838. Thank you so much once again for joining in today. Have a very safe day. Thank you so much. Take care. Thank you, Pankaji. Thank you, Taran sir. Thanks, Gaurav.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot.